Okay, I think we're on. How do you do, everyone? Welcome to this light-hearted wrap-up of 2020 from the investment consulting team at Altus. My name's Kevin O'Kell. I'm Managing Director of Altus, and I shall be the Master of Ceremonies for the next hour. For those of you unfamiliar with it, we're using a platform called On24 for this event, and we've laid the screen out in a way that should let you see the speakers and any content. You are welcome to move things around and rearrange it. If that seems to break anything at any point, or the slides stop moving for you, or you can't hear us, then try pressing F5 or Command R, apparently, if you're using an Apple, and that should fix it. There are some more options for interacting by the icons at the bottom of the screen. There is a group chat function in the form of some gingerbread men, if you want to ask questions or talk to each other. Careful before you slag me off, though, through that, because we can see what you're writing to. You can also download the slides and access the infographic that you'll see a bit later by clicking on the Christmas card icon. And you can check out all today's speakers by clicking on the snowman icon. Right. Next. Yeah, very good. So, on to the content. By general consensus, 2020 has been a pretty rubbish year. So we're going to try and cheer you up by picking out the best bits and ignoring the bad stuff. As you can see on the agenda here, we've arranged the next hour into a series of 5 short sessions designed more as light entertainment than education. So there are no CPD points on offer today, I'm very sorry to tell you. As well as hearing from members of our own illustrious team, we've also roped in a couple of hunks from the bobsleigh team that Altus is sponsoring this year. Brad Hall and Greg Cackett are Britain's number one bobsleigh crew, and you might have seen them on TV or the BBC website at the weekend. As well as competing in a World Cup race in Innsbruck, they were interviewed about a great charity initiative, which I'm sure they will tell you all about. But first, it's me, with a personal and irreverent perspective on 2020 based on my own experiences. My apologies in advance if I offend anyone with flippant comments, but looking on the bright side, for every one of you who puts up with me and is still with us at the end, Altus will donate £10 to a local homeless charity here in Bath. Based on the number of registrations and average attention spans, I estimate that will be in the region of £1,000. And that's pretty much the only connection to investment that you'll get from me for the rest of my slot. So, back in March, we locked up our office, sent everyone home with their laptops under their arms. And I thought that would just be for a few weeks. Wouldn't be too bad. I can play golf, do some networking. And then they closed all the golf courses. Never mind, I thought I've got plenty to get on with, and I can fill the sporting gap with subscriptions to every streaming sports service you can think of. So I had BT Sports, Sky Sport, Amazon Prime. I got the lot. And then the government turned off all professional sport, which meant I had nothing to do except work and household chores. Luckily, thanks to being so popular, I belong to numerous WhatsApp groups, and the monotony of the last 9 months has been relieved by a relentless stream of digital content. So I thought I would tell my 2020 story via the medium of WhatsApp jokes. And don't worry, I have cleaned them, only the appropriate ones will appear. I apologise in advance for any repeats that some of you may have already seen. So here goes my slides. Right. So in the early days before lockdown, we made fun of the name of the virus, and there were some cracking deals on beer in the supermarket. So when lockdown came, some of us, with the full fridges, turned to the bottle. The early rules seemed really extreme, so we made fun of them. And then when we realised the government was actually serious, we found humour in imagining ways to bend the rules. Then when one particular individual bent them too far, the nation got indignant and a whole new stream of jokes burst forth. This was about springtime, as you can tell. That stream flowed into a less harsh phase of the lockdown when the government allowed golf courses to open again and the world briefly seemed a better place. I used this term several times myself on golf course, where we had to make a few modifications to the way we played the game. Golf broke the monotony for a while for some of us, but many of us found that new virtual world was beginning to grind us down. I imagine some people will recognise that cartoon. And all the days started blurring into one. About this time, I started seeing more random jokes that didn't have a COVID theme, but some of them were still really funny. I had to include that because I really like that one. And by now, people were getting tired of the same old briefings from number 10. We saw some funny images around that. However, we consoled ourselves with the knowledge that we could have an even worse leader to handle the pandemic. I'll give you a few seconds to read that one. It's a bit longer, but I think pretty funny. And then infection rates. Oh, hang on, sorry, no. That chap also had some very interesting ideas on how to tackle the pandemic. And then infection rates started rising again over here, and we braced ourselves for more restrictions. A new tiered system was introduced, and the Southwest got off quite lightly, but we marvelled at the ingenuity of some of those in other tiers in the country. And then just as I thought we were running out of things to laugh at, we had the US presidential election, which went on for so long that the Democrat candidate seemed to forget the result, while the White House incumbent still refuses to accept it. And as the world's oldest democracy, we could only marvel at how silly US elections had become. All in all, 2020 has been a tough year. Some of us have drunk too much. Relationships have sometimes become strained. Some well-known businesses have struggled to stay relevant. And most of us have just had enough of it. But finally, we have some vaccines and the promise of normal life at some point ahead. So let's look forward to 2021 and the joys of Brexit. Finally being able to be British again, as summed up really eloquently here on this slide, my final slide, by a Swiss gentleman. So I hope you found something to laugh at in that little series of memes. And now it's time for me to hand over to the next act, Altus Platforms director Ben Hammond, who will regale and entertain you with some curious facts about his favourite part of the investment industry. Ben, over to you.
Excellent. Thanks, Kev, for that humorous introduction. So I'm going to talk a bit about platforms and some recent research that we've been doing, as well as just a little bit about the industry in general. So some of you may remember or may have attended our event, our Platform Wings event back in 2018, back when we were allowed to do things like go to Canary Wharf and admire the landscapes. So that's all good. So I'm sticking with the plane analogy. Might just chuck in Santa in his sleigh in the background to keep it slightly Christmassy. And going to talk a bit about that for the next 5-10 minutes or so. So some of you might remember this handsome chap at the end of my last presentation, so I thought I'd start with him. Well, he's still flying. He's also full of Christmas cheer, and not just because the golf courses are open again. Hope you enjoyed all the jokes there. So what we're finding, I'm going to give a short and hopefully humorous update. What we're finding is, alas, you know, in the world of actual planes, most jumbos have actually made a graceful exit. But those who can make it work are definitely back in the skies. Everyone wants to be more efficient. That's not just it happening in the last 9 months. Everyone's going to be a bit more dreamliner. And there's a big move, a big drive to move to things like e-signatures, but also many other stresses and strains in terms of regulatory change that platforms are having to be put up with. Thankfully, the FCA has delayed a few things until next year, but there's been plenty to keep platforms busy over the last few months, and indeed the whole of 2020. People at Hargreaves continuing to gather customers, make big profits. There's none of this going on like last time, to no engines on fire, unless you're thinking of Woodford or any trading issues due to the Pfizer vaccine that's recently started to be given out. So getting into the detail, what's life like on our plane at the moment? So last time we had a cup of cost and we were able to leave you with a takeaway from the event itself. This year, can't do that, unfortunately.